Hold it. I think you're going to like this picture.
Love That Bob. Starring Bob Cummings.
No, just a change. Car's picking me up. We're going bowling.
The potato chips are for the cheese dip.
Oh.
And the whole thing is for company.
Who's coming?
Some real estate people. They want to talk to us about selling the house.
This house? Our house?
They say it'll bring four times what it cost.
And so will the house they sell us. Then where are we?
In an apartment.
An apartment, Margaret?
Listen, what do we need with this big house? Chuck's away at school, you work all day, play all night.
There's going to be no apartment for me, Margaret. Walls this thin, the neighbors complaining. Landlords won't let you dance at night.
You lived in a house all your life. How come you know so much about apartments?
Sure. I've danced a few landlords out of bed, you know.
Oh, I'm sure you have. Oh, that must be the real estate people.
I'll get rid of the market.
Don't be rude. Bob, now listen. It won't hurt to see what kind of a figure they come up with.
Okay. Hiya, Margaret.
Barbie! Well, hi, Ruthie.
Oh, fine. I'll be ready.
Oh, well, he won't be long. He's just getting rid of a real estate salesman.
Oh.
Want some chip and dip or have you eaten?
No, no, I haven't. Bobby said we'd eat at the drive-in.
Oh, now what? What's a drive-in got that he can't get here?
I think her name's Arlene.
You know, I bet you spend more time at the drive-in tonight than you do at the bowling alley.
Oh, now, Margaret, please. A married man like me doesn't get out too often. As a matter of fact, tonight will be my first chance to use this bowling ball Bobby gave me.
When did he give you that?
Just before my wedding, 12 years ago. Oh, but am I going to fool Bobby tonight? He thinks that I am out of condition. Little does he know how housework can toughen a man up, believe me. You ready?
No, not just yet. I'm talking a deal on the house.
What?
Oh, Margaret, for heaven's sake. I thought you were going to save this for the real estate people.
You mean you're still here?
Well, you yourself said to see what kind of a figure they came up with.
Was it good?
Yes, just sensational. Just a little chicken dip.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Collins. It's very nice. Uh-huh. Mr. Collins, I know that you're a very busy man, so let's not waste any time.
I'm for that.
First of all, is the house clear?
No, my sis and a friend are in the kitchen, but I can get rid of them. I believe it's a good moment. This is over here. So many places I never get a chance to, Now, what in the world can this be?
Looks like wine.
Wine? Oh, of course. Margaret must use this for cooking. That's what it is. My goodness.
Well, she cooks in wine like that. You must have wonderful food.
Well, we got the craziest gravy in town, I can tell you that. Do you like this stuff? This, what is it? Champagne.
Well, no, not when I'm on a deal. It goes right to my head.
Really?
I forget about business.
My. Oh, by chance, have you noticed these rather unusual beams that support the subflooring in this house here?
They're extra heavy, aren't they?
Yes, they are. You see, I found these in an old ship that was wrecked right off the coast here. Uh-huh. Yes, I think they're teak wood.
What happened?
Oh, we must have blown a cork. Oh, I guess when I jiggled it, it sort of unsettled it. We really shouldn't let it go flat, should we?
No.
Have you any suggestions?
Yes. Why don't you take it upstairs and have your sister cook something in it?
Yeah, that's a good idea. All right, I'll be right back. Just wait.
Oh,
Marty. Bobby, where have you been?
Did the real estate man leave?
No. I was just going to give him a little drink.
Oh, now, Bobby, we're going bowling.
Well, good idea. That'll be wonderful exercise for Margaret.
Well, she's not going. You are.
Oh, Harv, no. I really can't see. I'm talking business.
Champagne, huh? This a little drink you're going to give him?
Well...
You didn't even want me to give him potato chips.
Margaret, that was before I realized the possibilities of this deal.
Looks good, huh?
Just great.
This real estate salesman must be quite a man.
You can look the world over, Margaret, and you won't find a man like this.
Go get her, huh?
As soon as you two leave.
What?
The sooner you two leave, the more bowling you're going to get in. See?
Oh, gee, Bob, Harvey doesn't want to go bowling with me.
Oh, Margaret, you're a wonderful bowler. You used to bowl all the time, honey.
Well, Margaret, if you'd like to go.
Oh, sure, I know she would. Come on, it's wonderful exercise.
It'll be fun.
Go on, Margaret. Get your things again. You'll have a wonderful time. Go on, honey.
Wonder where I put my bowling shoes. The last time... I know. The basement.
Oh, Bobby. But that realtor isn't going to drink champagne mixed with root beer.
That's the only way she will drink it, huh?
Well, because, you know, it's funny about selling a house, Bobby, because... Did you say she'll drink it?
Yes, I did.
Well, you know, anyway, Ruthie has always felt that... You did say she.
I most assuredly did, Harv. That little real estate agent is a living doll. She's down in the basement right now making her appraisal.
I already made mine.
He said that I cook with this. That's right. Listen, I better warn you. He's the one who cooks with champagne, if you know what I mean. But don't worry, because I've been wise to your brother ever since he opened the front door, wiggled his pointed ears, and howled, "Well, hello."
Well, now I understand why you suddenly decided to sell the house.
Harv, I have no intention whatever of selling this house.
Then why are you giving that real estate doll champagne?
12 years of marriage has kind of dulled your instincts, hasn't it?
Let's face it, Bobby, I'm pitiful.
Harv, I remember when you used to run wild with the pack.
Now I just limp home with a paycheck. All right, Margaret.
And, Bob, I wish you luck in your transaction with the realtor.
Oh, thanks, Mark. I'll try to make it a howling success.
Oh, I'm sure you will. Bye.
Bye. Bye, Harv. Why, I'm terribly sorry to have been so long.
What's this?
Oh. I just thought you might be a little thirsty. Do you like root beer by any chance?
I love it.
Good. I'll just pour you some. Just made it fresh.
Thank
Let
you.
Me see. What should we drink to? I know. We'll drink to real estate.
All right. Yeah. To your house.
Oh, thank you.
Root beer has an unusual flavor.
Yeah, it is good, though. Tell you what, I'll put on some music.
Music?
Well, yes, you see, the hi-fi goes with the house, so naturally, you should hear it.
Naturally.
That's a very good selling point. Excuse me, just a moment. These beams that I told you about that support the subflooring give this floor a wonderful resilience. And that's very important in these... You like root beer, don't you?
I adore it.
Like some more?
Oh, you drink yours first.
Oh, all right.
Oh, bottoms up. Oh. Refreshing, isn't it?
Yes. Let's fill them up again. There we go. Let me see. Now, what was I talking about? Oh, yes, the resilience of this floor. It's just simply wonderful for dancing. How about trying it?
Hmm?
Yes, but I meant dancing with someone. That's the way most people do it.
Oh, well, for that, don't you think music should be a little slower?
Slower? Yes, all right. I can fix that. Here, you just finish your root beer.
All right.
There. Now, that's a much better tempo. You know... I've never known anyone to enjoy a root beer like you do. Well, shall we dance?
Oh, Lynn, I suppose you drink yours first.
Right, just a sip.
Oh, no, no, no. Bottoms up.
Bottoms up.
Bottoms up. Have a certain goodness.
Goodness, yes. I guess real estate's a very fascinating business, isn't it?
Well, I think so. Of course, I love houses. They're so interesting.
That's probably because each one has its own character.
This one certainly has.
Oh, really? Did you notice it?
The moment you opened the front door.
Yes. Well, I guess that's because it reflects an air of refinement and...
It's root beer.
Yes. Would you like some more? You would, really?
Oh, but only if you'll join me.
All right. Here we are.
Well, here's how.
Good, I've been wondering how.
You're going to join me.
Oh, yes. Sorry. Here's Al.
Together or not at all.
Together. Down in the basement to open another bottle of root beer.
Bob, wake up. The people are here to see the house. Say, you know, that Miss Tuttle is really a live wire. You only gave her the listing last night. She's already got a couple who... Wake up. Bob? Wake up.
No, don't yell at me, Margaret. I'm very tired, very tired.
Please.
Miss Tuttle is downstairs. Miss Tuttle, the ravishing realtor.
Oh, her.
Yes.
Boy, she can really hold her root beer, Margaret. Do they make that stuff out of roots?
Yeah, I think so. I think they pound it or something and get the extract.
They'd better be careful. Those roots can pound back.
Well, just splash a little cold water on your face because Miss Tuttle wants to bring the couple upstairs.
Bring what upstairs?
The couple. You know, I told you Miss Tuttle was here with a couple.
A couple of what?
A couple of married people from Iowa who want to buy the house.
Margaret, I told you yesterday this house is not for sale.
Well, apparently you didn't tell Miss Tuttle that. In fact, you signed a contract with her last night giving her the exclusive right to sell it.
Margaret, what? Oh, no.
Oh, yes. In fact, this couple from Iowa seems ready to buy.
Over my dead body.
Oh, you're not dead. You just like to be.
Oh, Margaret, tell them the house is not available. It's unsafe. It's condemned.
Oh, they've already seen the house, all except the bedrooms, and they're just waiting until you're up to see those.
Look. Oh. I'm not up.
Say, you know, this just might help sell them.
What's that, Meyer?
They wanted to use this room for a nursery. And I'm going to tell them that the big stuffed wolf with the strawberry eyes goes with the room.
Excuse me. Miss Tuttle, my goodness, please forgive my appearance. I was just rushing down to warn you. The police are about to put a ticket on your car. How do you do?
What for?
I just saw them in my window. If you hurry, you can move it while they're circling the block.
Well, Mrs. Joker, this is Mr. Collins. I'll be right back.
Well, let's go in and see if the police nabbed her. Here we are. My, it's been a lovely day, hasn't it? If you... Oh, I'm sorry. I should have warned you. Don't step in this termite powder here. I better scoop that up before those buyers get here.
Termite powder?
Oh, yeah, but it doesn't kill them. These California termites are practically indestructible. It'll just drive them back into the woodwork long enough so Janice can con that Iowa couple into signing.
You have a lot of trouble with termites?
Trouble? I maintain that woodworking shop down in the garage just to replace what they eat. You know, being a friend of Janice's, you'll get a kick out of this. Her boss told her if she could sell this lemon, that he'd give her a double...
What is it?
Don't breathe, for heaven's sake.
Oh, do you...
Oh, please.
What?
Shh. Quiet. There. Now, we've got it cornered under the bed. You watch that end there.
What is it?
It's a bull termite, one of the biggest I've ever seen. Too late, too late. Once they bore into the floor like that, they're gone. I need this bed. I don't want a reoccurrence of what happened last summer.
Oh, Mr. Drucker, how did you like the workshop?
Oh, wonderful. In fact, the whole place is wonderful, and we'll take it.
Oh, no, we won't. I don't want to find my children lying in a heap on the living room floor.
But, honey, we're going to put the children in the nursery upstairs.
They'll wind up in a heap on the living room floor.
But,
Mrs.
honey...
Mrs. Drucker, I'm sorry, but you didn't get to see everything.
I saw enough. You're not selling us a nest of termites.
But,
hey, but
Mrs. Drucker... Termites?
We haven't got termites.
Of course not.
Bob, what happened?
Oh, Janice, I'm terribly sorry you lost this deal. But don't you worry. We'll get together tonight and we'll work...
Oh, no, I haven't lost the deal.
What?
No. In this state, a termite inspection is a routine requirement for selling a house. The pest control company has already been notified.
Oh, then they'll send an inspector over.
Mm-hmm. And as soon as he signs the clearance papers and I show him to the Druckers, we're back in business.
Oh, wonderful. I have to get dressed for a luncheon. But I know there's some hot coffee on the stove. Miss Tuttle would like some while she waits for the inspector.
Thank you, Mrs. McDonald.
I'll see you later.
Janice, look. You don't have to wait for that inspector. I'll get the papers and I'll bring them over to you when I pick you up this evening.
No, really. I think I'd rather... That's probably him now.
Oh, I'll let him in. Just sit down. Make yourself comfortable. Be right back. Excuse me.
Hi, Bobby. Oh. Say, Bobby, how do you like this new suede jacket I got last night for being the 1,000,000th customer of the bowling alley? How do I look?
Termite inspector. Oh, yes. Come right this way, sir. I'll show you.
Where we go? Watch out. Watch out.
Oh, here we are. I'm terribly sorry to have been so long, but I had to show the termite inspector the crawl hole under the house.
Oh, he's here.
Yes, and hard at work. Cream and sugar?
No, thank you.
I guess I really should have given you some of that root beer you were so crazy about last night.
Well, I'm glad you didn't. That's a terrible thing to do to good champagne.
Can I use your phone, Mac? I got a call for help.
Who's he?
Well, I don't know. I think it's the termite inspector, but he's so covered with sawdust.
This ain't sawdust, Mac. This is termite table scraps.
What?
It's all...
You mean you actually found termites?
Termites? Lady, this whole house is just one big Pinewood blue plate special. A little snack they made out of this house support.
For goodness sake. Look at that. Oh, well, gee, can't you kill them or something?
Oh, yeah. But I wouldn't advise it. It's mating season.
What do you mean?
Well, you see, if those termites ever stop holding hands, this whole place will collapse. As a matter of fact, Mac, I don't need the phone. As a matter of fact, I'm getting out of here.
Oh, Janice, wait a minute now. I'm sorry. Don't feel so bad. After all, you still have me. I mean, as a customer, of course.
Well, that's right. You'll have to find another place to live, won't you?
Yes. Well, I'll tell you what, we can start looking tonight.
After dark?
Yeah, that's the best time. I mean, to select a general area. I understand that there's a vantage point which overlooks both San Fernando Valley and Beverly Hills. It's a hilltop called Mull Amsterdam or Mull Dutch or something like that. And
Mull Holland?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, we could have dinner, and then if I can find it, we can drive up there later. Okay?
Okay.
See you at 7.
7. 5. Miss Tuttle. Janice. I was listening on the stairs. This whole thing is a phony from the termite inspector right on.
Yes, I know.
But you said that, listen, Mulholland is a phony, too. He's only taking you up there because you're a pretty girl.
That's all right. I'm only going because he's a handsome man. Bye.
Of Harvey Helm was played by King Donovan, Hazel Drucker by Mimi Walters, and Sam Drucker by Kevin Burke. The part of Janice Tuttle, the ravishing realtor, was played by Bob's special guest, Elena Verdugo. This is Bill Baldwin speaking.